Welcome to this Yamaha discovery video on using the MIDI Song to Style application. With this application, you can convert any standard MIDI file to a style. MIDI Song to Style is available for both Windows and Mac and can be downloaded from the link in the description of this video. To get started, open the application and drag and drop in your MIDI file. A conversion analysis of the MIDI file starts immediately. After analysis, there's two application modes to choose from, Easy and Edit. In Easy mode, your new style has already been automatically created and is ready to play on your Arranger workstation. It just needs saving. Click on the Save Style button, opening a window where there's a choice of two save options. If you're using your computer standalone, you can save and transfer the style to your Arranger workstation using USB memory. Or, if your computer and instrument are connected via USB, you can save it directly to your Arranger workstation. Connecting your computer and Arranger workstation is straightforward. Start by connecting a USB cable between the two host port on your Arranger workstation and a USB port on your computer. Next, in the MIDI Song to Style application, click the MIDI Settings icon. Use the drop-down menus to set a MIDI input device and a MIDI output device. Click OK to confirm the settings. With a USB connection, not only can you transfer styles directly to your instrument, but now you can hear the original MIDI file being played back on your connected Arranger workstation. Or play back any of your new style sections on your Arranger workstation. The first time you choose to play back a style section, the Chord Palette window opens. Here you can even change the chord used during style playback. You can choose a chord manually, or if you turn off a comp on your Arranger workstation, style playback is controlled by the chords you play. All of this in easy mode. Now let's take a look at edit mode, where you can really personalize your style. All of the easy mode functions we've covered so far are also available in edit mode. The layout is just slightly different. In edit mode, you can now see the tracks of the original MIDI file and choose to mute them individually during playback. At the start of the song to the left, Edit Mode's timeline shows an overview of the music contained in each of the MIDI file's tracks. Just like in Easy Mode, you can play back each of the style's sections. The Chord Palette window opens automatically when playback is first started. Click to close the Chord Palette. Now you can see highlighted in the timeline the areas of the MIDI file used to create each of the style sections. Currently, these areas have been chosen automatically. To change the order of the style sections, click on a style section in the timeline. Then, once selected, click it again. A new window opens. Choose which style section the selected area of the MIDI file should become and then click Assign. You can freely choose which areas of the MIDI file are used to create each section of your new style. Adjust one of the existing style sections by clicking and dragging it. Or select a new area of the MIDI file you wish to use for a style section. Use the zoom control for more accurate adjustments. When you're happy with your selection, press the plus button. Now choose which style section the selected area should become and click assign. You can repeat this process for each style section. To delete any unwanted style sections, right-click on them in the timeline and choose delete. When a style section is selected in the timeline, Each of the style's instrumental parts are shown over their corresponding track in the MIDI file. Simply drag and drop to swap which style part is assigned to what track of the MIDI file. You can mute any of the style parts by clicking on them. Click again to unmute. You can remove any unwanted parts in the selected styles section by clicking minus. For the selected style section, any tracks in the MIDI file which are not currently assigned to a style part and contain performance data have a plus symbol. Click the plus symbol to assign the track to a style part. In order for a style section to work correctly with different chord types, the source key's signature needs to be correct. The application estimates the key signature for each style section automatically, but you override this with manual settings. Sometimes the automatic analysis of the original MIDI file may not produce the results you wanted. In these cases, click the Reanalyze setting button to fine-tune how the analysis works. There are two tabs, Melody and Assign. In the Melody tab, to improve the analysis, select any tracks in the MIDI file which are melodic, like the lead line of a song, or those you want to play yourself. In the Assign tab, you can prevent any of the MIDI file tracks from being automatically assigned to a style part during analysis. Click Reanalyze to analyze the MIDI file with your new settings. In the detailed edit window, you can change the voice used by each MIDI channel. MIDI Song to Style application uses the Genos 2 voice list as default. However, a growing number of Arranger workstations are supported and voice lists can be downloaded from the product page of compatible instruments. At any time on the File drop-down menu, you can save all of your current style adjustments as a project file and load them next time you open the application. We recommend mixing your style at the end, just before saving. You can remix your style by adjusting the volume of the style parts. When you're happy with your new style, click the Save Style button and choose how to save your new style. Thanks for watching, and be sure to look out for our further Yamaha Discovery videos.